to the elect. We have not the spirit of fear. Truth and faith shall prevail. Want to give all the honor, glory, and praise to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem Rabbacha Kodash. That bonus to my elders at Great Millstone, taught me the truth through the Spirit, saying honors to the elect. Peace and blessings to the one third, and to the confusion of faces in the four corners of the earth. Shalom. Luke 12 and 32. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Understand that fear is the beginning of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. But in Wisdom of Solomon, it also says that fear is you not trusting in your succor. Succor is another word for aid or help. S-U-C-C-O-R, if I'm not mistaken. O-U-R. And that's not believing in the Ruach HaKodesh or the faith that we have. Because you can see what's going on in the world. I think it was yesterday. Brother Lawat sent me a link, and that was like a mass shooting. A serial killer, so to say. Did I say that right now? In Maine. If I'm not mistaken, like, there were like 20 people who were deceased, and like 50, 60 victims in multiple locations. So just imagine in this civil society, right, where you can dial 911 if your house is on fire and they'll put the fire out. You have individuals like this running around that's actually doing this, whether it's some MK Ultra or whether it's somebody who's just giving up on America, you know, Edomite, or just it's all going bad. Imagine when it's really a dog-eat-dog world. It's going to be wicked out here. But that's the reason why we are. That's the reason why we are here, to warn our people of what's to come. And only for the elect who shall get it, and they shall be saved. So what do we have to fear, right? But I can understand, because we're sheep. A sheep is not a predator. A sheep is docile, right? It needs a shepherd. And that's why you have something known as a German shepherd or an Australian shepherd, which I love as well, right? To guide them. This is Isaiah 41 and 8 through 14. But thou, Israel, art my servant, Jacob, whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend. Right? Our forefather, he referred to our forefather as his friend. Why do you think we have the covenant? It's not because of us, it's because of him. Or should I say them? Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Right? Thou, whom I have taken from the ends of the earth, and called thee from the chief men thereof, and said unto thee, thou art my servant, I have chosen thee, and not cast thee away. You hear that? The Lord hasn't cast us away. Yes, those curses are here, but remember, every time you read it in the Bible, if you're reading it Isaiah or Jeremiah or Ezekiel or Micah, every time you're reading about the prophets who was in captivity. So every time Israel went into captivity, the prophets were in captivity. Where are we right now? In captivity. Okay? So we're not cast away. The Lord always had a small sanctuary. Isaiah 41 and 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. We say, I am with thee. What do Yahweh shall say? I am with you to the end of the world. That word world is eon, meaning time. And you go to 2nd Edges, the 6th chapter, the 7th verse on down, it says that Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. And the kingdom will be here on earth. Okay? Isaiah 54 and 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. So we're judged of no man, because our judgment is not our own. Our judgment is of Yahweh Bahashim Yahushai. This is of no private interpretation. So you can't judge us based upon what we're speaking, because it's the Lord's judgment. So you despising him, not us. So you just condemning yourself. That's why it says in Matthew 12 and 36, every idle word that proceedeth out of man's mouth, he must give account for in that day. Even the thoughts in your mind. That's why I said, the Lord perceived or understood the thoughts of the wicked scribes and Pharisees, man. He read their minds and he spoke on what they was thinking. They were like, how the hell he knew? What make you think that he that make the ear can't hear? He that made the mouth can't talk. All right. Or he that made the eyes ain't looking. The Lord see all things. The eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than the sun. Behold all the ways of men. If the Lord told Jeremiah that I've known thee in the womb and I ordained thee a prophet, meaning that I already knew you going to be a prophet before your father and mother came together, what make you think that he don't know what you thinking, man? Come on now. Anyhow, continue Isaiah 54:17. Verse 17, continuing. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith Yahweh. So in other words, when we speaking, it's not us that speaking, it's the Spirit of the Father that speaketh in us, Matthew 10:20. So now you gotta take it up with Papa. You gotta take it up with Abba. Alright, mi padre. You know, big Papa up there. And then we got big brother who he put in charge of all things. Right? So, Proverbs 15:33, the fear of Yahweh is the instruction of wisdom, and before honor is humility. So, Yahweh Shabbos went through humility, and now he's on the right-hand side of the Lord. So, we're going to go through very hard and tough times, and we're being humiliated right now, but we're looking to be exalted and to rule Yahweh Shabbos for 1,000 years. So, we don't have nothing to fear. We got faith, man. We got truth. This is winning. We're winning right now. They have to be carnal because they can't fight us spiritually. They have to be carnal. They can't be spiritual. Right? So, I'm going to close out with this precept for the elect. This is 2 Ezra chapter 16, verse 74 and 76. Hear, O ye my beloved, Salaki, saith the Lord. Behold, the days of trouble are at hand. Yes, it's going to be terrible out here. But you must remember, even though the evil's coming, the Lord's going to give his angels charge over us. The Lord said, 1,000 shall die by thy side and none shall touch thee. The Lord got, what is scripture clear? Hold on, wait a minute. Ain't it Psalms 34:7? The angel of the Lord encampeth around about him that fear him. And remember, the 1/3 consists of mainly women and children. So yeah, when it says him, I understand that, but it also means those who believe, members of the body of Yahweh Shah, the 144,000 and the 1/3. Because remember, there were women who were weeping for Yahweh Shah. They believed. There were women that were weeping for Yahweh Shah. Alright? Remember the woman that washed Yahweh Shah's feet with her hair? What woman would do that today? Okay. But anyhow, going back 2nd Ezra chapter 16. Verse 74, hear, O ye my beloved, saith the Lord, behold, the days of trouble are at hand, but I will deliver you from the same. Jacob's trouble, right? Oh, that's heavy. I ain't even think about it, but it just popped up in my mind. Jacob's trouble. Let's get it. Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 7. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. Who? The elect. I forgot which brother said. I think it was, was it Shaw? Might have been Shaw. Brother said, it's going to be so bad, I hear the Lord going to have to send Michael the archangel. That brother made me, he stopped me in my track. I thought about it. I said, damn, you right. It's going to be that bad. He has to send one of the archangels to protect us. So we should be joyous of that. Despite the fact it's going to be bad, that bad, he's going to send an archangel is to protect us. Whew. Remember what the scripture says. Be not concerned with how the wicked shall be destroyed, but be concerned with how the righteous shall be saved. That's us. Right? So, going back. 2nd Ezra chapter 16, verse 75. Be ye not afraid, neither doubt, For God, Yahweh, is your guide. Man's goings are of the Lord. The Lord will guide us into salvation. That's heavy. Whew. And the guide of them who keep his commandments. The law's done away with. Well, who the hell guided you? Yourself? Ha! What the scripture say about the mind? It said the heart is desperately wicked above all things. Who can know it? The heart is deceitful and desperately wicked. Desperately wicked above all things. My mind playing tricks on me. That's how you over there looking goofy. Because you trust, you bet it on yourself? Okay. Close out. 2nd Ezra chapter 16, verse 76. And the guide of them who keep my commandments and precepts, saith the Lord God, let not your sins weigh you down. We in the flesh, y'all. Don't worry about that. If you worry, if that what you worrying about, listen, are you doing what he asked you to do? Okay. Are you willfully sinning? That's different. All right, then you good. Let not your sins weigh you down, and let not your iniquities lift up themselves. So if you have the Ruach HaKodesh, you can still see these prophecies. You can still call on the name of Yahweh Hashem Hashem when you pray. You can still see the miracles. You can still see the Lord is moving and grooving. And you ever get a doubt in your mind, just remember, that's just Satan. That's just Satan. He's trying to get you to come over on his side before it's too late. Why you want to join a losing team? Why you want to move your furniture into a burning house? Why you want to get into a car that's sitting on bricks? I catch my drift, right? And I ain't even driving. Come on now. Right? Hey, what did Paul say? Be followers of me as I am of Hamashiach. Right? So we all following. We all on the same path, following the same entity. Only difference is that we're doing what he told us to do. And everybody else trying to do it the other way. But yeah, like he said, there's only one way to the Father. And that's through the only begotten Yahweh Shai, Hamashiach. So with that being said, pray you at 5 fed. Stay in the spirit. No fear. Just endure it. Ask for forgiveness. Pray without ceasing. Stay humble. Remain diligent. For Masha'Allah. Mofla Babal. Shalom.